Welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I'm going to advance a little bit more on the debugging aspect of our game. We've currently created a player with run and idle animations and player state, but currently we haven't created any output statements in our source code to help us when we want to debug through our source code. So let's begin by opening up our player. Once the scene is open, click on to your script. In the player script, we have our player idle function, our player run function. Let's run the game. And we can now run right and run left, and we've got the idle state. However, when we are debugging our code, we don't see any output, or we may wish to see some output when we write some of our code statements. So let me show you how we can do that. So stop the game and go back to your player script. So we have our player idle function and our player run function. What I would like to do is output some print statements to our output window when the game is running. And I'd like to see, when is my player in the idle state? So this is easy. We can just say print and put state and current state and put this into a string function as an enum will be an int, and then copy this statement and place it after your current state after we set that to run. Now let's run the game. I'll just minimize this a little bit. So this is coming out at state 0. Really, we want that to say idle. So let's go back to the script. And let's modify this statement here. So delete the string current state because it's just converting the enum integer value just straight out. So that's why we're getting a 0 and a 1. And to convert the current state enum to a string, we say state dot keys and then current state and copy and paste this into run. And run the game again. We'll just minimize this a little bit. So as you can see in our output window, we are now getting idle. And that's because the player is currently in that idle state. So let's go left and right. So we'll go left, got run. And as you can see, it is switching between run and idle. So as soon as you lift the key, it's going back to idle and then holding it down, and then it's going through. And that's how we are getting our run animation and run state working. So that is a way on how to output logic within your source code into print statements onto your screen. And if you go back to the script, if we pop a breakpoint onto our line, so if you just hover over your line number where you would like to add the breakpoint, just click this and it will add that in. And then when you move again on the game, so let's move, you can see this breakpoint has been hit. And then what we can do, we can look at the variable. So you just click onto your editor and then you can just hover over your variable to get that value. If you also look into your stack trace, the stack frame here will show you at what function is currently in focus. So we're currently in the player run function, but it's come from the physics process. So it's gone through physics process, player run, and then it's arrived here. It's telling you what line we're currently executing on, which is line 41, which corresponds to line number. And then if you look at your filter stack variables, you can see your variables here. So you can see you've got your direction and your current state. But how do you see other objects? So if we have a look in our scripts, we've got an onReady variable of animated sprite 2D. And you can see your object here. So if we did want to inspect this, you can click this value here and it will load up the object here and you click remote. So you can see the remote object. You've got your animated sprite. This is in your real time or live debugging. And then if you look in your inspector here, you can see the values that are being affected by that. Now, we're not going to go into this in any more detail in this tutorial, but in future tutorials, when we start to add more complex objects and complex nodes, we will start to debug using some of these concepts on here. But for now, I hope that this makes it a little bit easier to view some of the information that is coming from your scripts by using print statements and then using the breakpoint here. And just one last thing, if you do want to step through your source code, once you're on a breakpoint here, you can use F10, which will step over, F11, which will step into the function, and F12, which will continue the execution. So as you can see, because of the physics processes looping around and being continually called, you'll see that is also continually called. Now that brings us to the end of this tutorial on how to do some simple print output statements in your debug and to how to set some breakpoints. If you like what you've seen, please remember to click like and subscribe and come along and visit me on my next tutorial. Thank you for watching.